This lecture is about internal thoracic artery, its cores, relations and branches. Internal thoracic artery, which supplies anterior thoracic wall, abdominal wall from clavicle to umbilicus. First of all, we will discuss its cores. Internal thoracic artery. Internal thoracic artery basically arises from the inferior aspects of the subclavian artery. It descends medially behind the first costal cartilage. Then it descends downward vertically behind the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth costal cartilage up to the sixth intercostal space. Then at the level of the sixth intercostal space, it divides into superior epigastric artery or musculophrenic artery. Again, internal thoracic artery, which arises from the inferior aspect of subclavian artery, it descends medially behind the first costal cartilage. Then it descends vertically downward. At the level of the sixth intercostal space, it divides into two terminal branches. First branch is superior epigastric artery, second branch is musculophrenic artery. Internal thoracic artery is accompanied by two veni commitants. These two veni commitants unite at the level of the fourth costal cartilage to form internal thoracic vein or internal mammary vein. Internal thoracic vein finally opens or ends into brachiocephalic vein. Again, internal thoracic artery is accompanied by two veni commitants. These two veni commitants unite at the level of the fourth costal cartilage. Then they form internal thoracic vein. Internal thoracic vein finally opens into the brachiocephalic vein. Now we will discuss relations of internal thoracic artery in its upper part and lower part. In its upper part, anteriorly, first costal cartilage is present and sternal end of the clavicle is present anteriorly. Anteriorly, some other structures are also present like internal jugular vein, which drains into the brachiocephalic vein. Anteriorly, we also have brachiocephalic vein. Anteriorly, we also have phrenic nerve. Now we will come to its lower part. Lower part, anteriorly, we have a pectoralis major muscle. Anteriorly, we have external intercostal membrane. As we have discussed before, external intercostal membrane, which extends from costo-chondral junction to the lateral border of sternum. We have internal intercostal muscles. We have pectoralis major muscle in its outer side and intercostal nerves. Posteriorly, in its upper part, we have parietal pleura and endothoracic fascia. What is endothoracic fascia? Endothoracic fascia is basically a layer of deep connective tissue present deep to the intercostal spaces and ribs, separating these structures from the underlying pleura. Again, this is a layer of deep connective tissue which is present deep to the ribs and intercostal spaces, separating these structures from the pleura. In its lower part, posteriorly, sternocostalis muscle is present. Sternocostalis muscle, as we have discussed before, originates from posterior surface of the sternum, posterior surface of the xiphoid process, posterior surface of the lower true costal cartilages. And this muscle, sternocostalis muscle, separates the internal thoracic artery from the pleura. Now we will discuss some branches of internal thoracic artery. Internal thoracic artery give pericardiophrenic artery, pericardiophrenic artery which supplies pericardium and pleura. Internal thoracic artery also give mediastinal branches supply the mediastinum as well as pericardium, front of pericardium and thymus. Internal thoracic artery at the level of the sixth intercostal space divides into two terminal branches. Superior epigastric artery and musculophrenic artery. Internal thoracic artery in the first six intercostal spaces. In each space, internal thoracic artery give two anterior intercostal arteries. From first to sixth intercostal spaces, internal thoracic artery give two anterior intercostal arteries in each space. In 7, 8, 9 intercostal space, two anterior intercostal arteries in each space is given by musculophrenic artery. Musculophrenic artery later on anastomose with underlying arteries of the diaphragm. Superior epigastric artery passes between the sternal and costal origins of the diaphragm and anastomose with inferior epigastric artery. Internal thoracic artery also gives some perforating branches. Perforating branches of second, third, fourth are larger in female to supply the breast. This was all about some branches of internal thoracic artery.